What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to back up Active Directory using Windows Server Backup. So let's get right into it. All right, so first things first, you know, using Windows Server Backup to back up any of your servers, you have two options to where you want to drop your backup. You have locally, or you have a network share. Now, I feel like best practice is to drop it in a network share, not locally, because, you know, if something happens to the server and you need to recover, the backup is locally. How are you going to get that local backup if the machine is down? Whatever, right? So dropping it into a network share is the best practice in my eyes. So I didn't have a file share to drop my backup into. So the first thing that I did was create a server. Now, I created a server, a Windows Server 2022. I called it File Share. Makes sense. And I need to install the file server services. So I'm going to click on Start. I'm going to locate and click on Server Manager. It's going to load up. On the upper right-hand side, I'm going to click on Manage. Within here, let's click on Add Roles and Features. You're going to get the wizard. Let's click Next here. Next again. And within here, we're going to expand file and storage services. Awesome. We're going to expand again, file and iSCSI services. And the one that we want to kind of enable would be the file server. So just give it a check mark. Okay. Click on next. Click next here. If you want, you could click on restart the destination server automatically if required. You're going to get the nice little warning that if a restart is required, it is going to restart. So click yes here, click install. Once the installation is done, you're going to get this. This is awesome. Now, you know, installing the file server services, you don't really need a restart. I just like checking that just in case it does and I forget to restart, it would do it for me automatically. Now, let's close this up. And from here on the left-hand side, we're going to click on file and storage services, and you're going to get this kind of window, and we're going to click on shares. Now, I don't have any shares, so let's create one. Click on the task menu. Cool. Let's click on new share. You're going to get this wizard. You're going to have multiple options to create a particular profile. I'm going to keep it super simple, and I'm going to create a SMB share quick. So click on next. From here, you pick where you want to drop your share folder. I'm going to leave it as a C drive. Best practice is most likely you have a partition. But because this is a small lab, I'm going to do everything within the C drive. All right. So once you click next, you're going to get this. Provide a share name. So give it a name. I give it the following. And also give a location of where you want to drop your share. So, you know, it's automatically going to go inside a C drive, inside a folder called shares, and whatever name you provide your share name, it's going to be the same name as the folder. So for me, it would be backups, and it's going to create a folder called backups. You also have the UNC path. Make sure you jot that down because that is how you're going to access it remotely. We're also going to need that UNC path to back up. So click next here. I'm going to leave all these settings as the default. Click next for permissions. I'm going to leave it as the default, but you are able to modify it. It's all up to you. By default, share permissions is set to everyone, full control. But because this is a small lab and this is my lab, I'm going to leave it as is. But best practice is you want to kind of like lock it down. Click next. A nice little confirmation. Click on create. It creates it pretty fast. So it's pretty simple. So close this. And there goes our share. Now, if you open up the File Explorer, we're going to the C drive. Within the C drive, we're going to go into the folder called shares because that is what was created for us. And inside the shares, you're going to see our new share folder that we created, which was called backups. File server is already done. It is time to get into our domain controller and install Windows Server Backup. So let's head into my DC01. And within here, we're going to click on Start. We're going to click and locate Server Manager. It's going to load up. On the upper right-hand side, we're going to click on Manage. Let's click on Add Roles and Features. You're going to get the wizard. So let's click Next here. Click Next again. Click Next again. And within here, we are going to click Next because what we want is a feature. So let's scroll all the way down, locate Windows Server Backup. Let's give it a check mark. Let's click Next here. If you want, let's click on, well, I like to do this. I'm going to check off restart the destination server automatically if required. You're going to get a nice little warning. So just click on Yes. Click on Install. It's going to start installing. Once it's completed, installation is succeeded. Awesome. Most likely it's not going to restart, but again, I like checking that off in case it needs it. So it's already done. So let's click on Close. And within here, within the server manager on the upper right-hand side, let's click on Tools and locate Windows Server Backup and then click on it. It's going to load up. Let's click on Local Backup and we don't have any backups as of yet. So on the right-hand side, let's click on Backup Once. Now, you are able to schedule your backups, but I just want to do a one-off real quick and Backup Options is the way to go because I don't have a backup. So once the wizard is up and running, let's click on Next. We're going to do a full server. You are able to do a custom, but a full server will actually do everything that you need within your domain controller, backing up the Active Directory, system volume, partitions, and the share folders, and the Active Directory database. So a full backup server will give you what you need. So I'm going to leave it as is. Let's click on Next. And this is what I was talking about earlier. You have two options to drop your backup, either local drives, which is not really a best practice kind of thing. I mean, if you have a partition, you could drop it into, and if something happens to the machine, you could probably do some type of recovery and get into the partition to get the backup. So I'm going to pick remote shared folder. Let's click Next. Specify the location, that UNC path that we received when we created our file server. I'm going to add it here. I'm going to keep the access control as is. Let's click Next. And this is everything that's going to be backed up. This is awesome. Yes, we want the bare metal recovery. We want the C drive. We want the system state. So let's click Backup. And please wait. Eventually, it's going to change. It's going to start backing up. All right. So once the backup is done, it's going to take you here. Awesome. Everything completed successfully. Pretty self-explanatory. We're going to click on Close. This is our backup, our first successful backup. If you double click on it, it gives you a nice overview of what has been backed up. This is awesome. Now, let's close this up. And if we head over to our file share server, this is my file share server, and I'm going to open up the File Explorer. Let's go into the C drive. And within the C drive, let's go into the folder called Shares. And within Shares, let's go into Backups. And within backups, you're going to see another folder that was created during the backup process called Windows Image Backup. Now, if you double click on that, you're going to see the name of the server. So if you're doing multiple servers or different servers, inside the Windows Image Backup folder, inside there, you're going to see each individual server, the name of them, and they're going to have their own folder with the backups. Now, if you open up the DC01, you're going to see everything that you need to recover your domain controller or your Active Directory. That's awesome, right? So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one.